Hello friends, Terry Games is back with a new playthrough of Detroit Become Human.
Hello, welcome to the Detroit Experience. I'm an android and I'll be your hostess.
Thank you.
Hello, I hope you're doing well. What would you like to do today?
Are we good? I think we're good. Yes, hello, welcome to Detroit Become Human. This is a brand new playthrough series that I'm doing. I'll give you a little insight. I did play this once before, but the interesting thing about Detroit Become Human is, for this game, no matter how many times you play this game, the storyline always changes of what your decision is every time you play on. So maybe it'll be the same playthrough I did the first time I played it. Maybe it'll be a brand new event I've never done before. So it'll be pretty interesting. But now it is time for you guys to experience.
If you find the game too easy or too difficult, remember you can change the difficulty settings in the options section.
No, I don't think we'll need to change the options, but it's time for you guys to experience what Detroit Become Human is all about. So, let's get into it. Start it off with a new story. Your story will be updated as soon as you... Yes. So, start a new story of Detroit Become Human. Give you a little insight before we get into the game. Starts off the main characters of three characters each. And here's our first one. Controlling. You can interact with your right analog stick. See what I mean? You can do different decisions as your game progresses. So I can save the fish, or I can leave them. I think I'm gonna save him. Put him back in the fishing tank. Why? Because I'm a nice guy. I don't like seeing fish like that. Fish need water,
please,
you know?
Please, you gotta save my little girl. Wait. You're sending an android?
All right, ma'am. You need to go.
You can't do that. You... Why aren't you sending a real person?
Yeah, as you guys could tell, that was the downside I didn't say. You're playing as androids. Each character that we play are androids, so we're not as real humans. What I'm doing now is pressing the R2 button, interacting stuff, looking around the room, seeing what things I can interact with. Try not to speak too much so you guys can experience as much of this as possible.
Captain Allen, my name is Connor. I'm the android sent by CyberLife.
It's firing at everything that moves. It already shot down two of my men. We could easily get it, but they're on the edge of the balcony. If it falls, she falls.
Have you tried its deactivation codes?
The first thing we tried.
Do you know its name?
Listen. Saving that kid is all that matters. So either you deal with this fucking android now, or I'll take care of it.
Well, I guess that was one bad decision that we did. So we could see, understood what happened here, or we could save the hostage, so... I'm gonna try and understand what happened here, at least a little bit, first. It looks like, oh, we can analyze. Missing things, like a missing gun, it looks like. 355 ammunition. There's some missing bullets. So it looks like we could replay what happened here. So looks like you closed the briefcase. Father's gun. But why did he take the father's gun? Well, I'll find out. Search hostage's room. Must be his or her room. Looks like it's her, so. See what's in here. Seen something on the floor. Stuff around here, so let's try to. Oh.
All units hold positions.
Figure out what happened. What happened to this guy? Looks like he got a bullet wound into his chest. One in his stomach. Guard his lungs. Upper lung. It's John Phillips. He was deceased. So let's figure out what happened to Mr. John Phillips. He fell off or something. He got shot. Who was shooting him? Daniel must have shot him. from behind. Father was holding something. Now rewind the search for a clue. So he reacted, he saw the gun. He shoots, bam, he dies. Couple bullets more, falls back. What's that over there? What have we found over here? Figure out what happened fast. It's getting crazy.
Yeah.
Let's go into the kitchen. Nothing in there. Let's examine this.
Thus, if confirmed, this would be the first case of an android deliberately taking human lives. By all signs, the SWAT team are preparing for an assault, and it's been just over an hour since Connor was taken hostage on the top floor of a building here in downtown Detroit. Details are still emerging on what exactly happened, but the hostage taker could be the family's android.
World knows. Family was about to have dinner, so whatever happened, they were about to eat.
I saw this leg move.
Examine this guy. Thanks for doing your service, pal. Right heart, shot in the heart. Anthony. This guy's name Anthony. Gunshot residue from his hand to the gun. So let's figure out what happened to this poor man. So he gets up. About to get shot. What's that over there? Hostage witnessed the shooting, so he has a kid hostage. What do we have here? Cop shot the deviant. So, a cop shot him, but fortunately, a cop got more worst than he did. That's what it looks like. He got shot. Yep, he went for it. Got a better target. Yeah, sorry, dude. What do we have down there? There's his gun. So it should be still under the table. Yep, it's right there. Let's try and grab it. There we go. I'll just leave it and put it back because I don't feel safe grabbing it. So,
what are we waiting for? We should take down
this. We have this. What's this on the floor? Blue blood. Model PL600. What's this on the ground? Well, looks like the witness's shoe. Or the hostage's shoe. Could be wounded. Looks like. What else do we have to do? Locate the hostage. Oh, he's got her. Gunpoint. There's nothing else here to do. Give one more quick look. I don't think there's anything else to do. What do y'all think in this game so far? Oh, there is something else to do. Nothing in the bathroom. I think we have all that we need. So, ladies and germs, let's go confront this hostage. Oh shit.
Don't come any closer or I'll jump!
Everybody, this is what Detroit's all about.
Hi, Daniel. Now, my name is Connor. How do you know my name? I know a lot of things about you. I've come to get you out of this.
Gain his trust and slowly approach. So let's try to gain his trust first before we move anywhere.
I know you're angry, Daniel, but you need to trust me and let me help.
I don't want your help. Nobody can help me. All I want is for all this to stop. I just want all this to stop.
I know you and Emma were very close. You think she betrayed you, but she's done nothing wrong.
She lied to me. I thought she loved me, but I was wrong. She's just like all the other humans.
Daniel, no!
They were going to replace you, and you became upset. That's what happened, right? You thought I was part of the family. You thought I mattered. But I was just their tool. Something to throw away when you're done. Listen. I know it's not your fault. These emotions you're feeling are just errors in your software.
No. It's not my fault. I never wanted this. I love them. You know? But I was nothing to them. Just a slave to be ordered around. I can't stand that noise anymore! Tell that helicopter to get out of here!
Let's do what he says. We're doing pretty good so far. Let's get him out of here.
The situation is under control!
There! I did what you wanted! Trust me, Daniel. Let the hostage go, and I promise you, everything will be fine. I want everyone to leave! And I want a car. When I'm outside the city, I'll let her go. That's out of the question. You're a machine, you have to obey. Now put the gun down and let the hostage go. I've spent my life taking orders. Now it's my turn to decide.
Oh no. We succeeded, but we've failed saving our main character. So here comes our second main character of Detroit Become Human.
This is the top of the range household assistant. It cooks 10,000 different dishes.
Come on, Zoe, let's go.
And diamonds. And handles the kids' elementary school. Good afternoon.
Honey, it
each
looks
each main
amazing.
Character has their own story.
This is
story
exactly line. What we need.
How much did you save, Thomas?
So unfortunately for our first storyline,
it does absolutely all the work.
He failed
painting, plumbing, gardening
to successfully save our first main character. So hopefully for this one we don't have that same luck and we can keep this one alive. Hopefully we don't have anything like that.
There it is. It's a bit difficult getting it back and working on it. It was really messed up. What'd you say happened to it again?
The car hit it. Stupid accident.
Ah, I see. Anyway, it's as good as new now, except that we had to reset it. Meaning we had to wipe its memory. I hope you don't mind.
It'll be fine.
Okay. Did you give it a name?
My daughter did.
AX400, register your name.
Kara.
My name is Kara.
Well, the second name character is Kara. We have not got a name for a first one yet. I guess you can call this part the opening of Detroit Become Human. Hey, did you see that Clancy Brown? Fun fact, Clancy Brown was voiced for Dr. Neo Cortex for Crash Bandicoot. So, wonder what he'll do here. Thank you. written and directed by David Cage. Here is our third and final main character that we're going to look at.
Would you like to go home now?
Yes, please. Yes, I think that's enough.
Here. Let me help.
Identification verified. Here is your order number 847. That will be $63.99. Please confirm payment.
Payment confirmed.
Transaction complete.
Where the fuck you going, Tin Can?
Hmm?
No kidding. Hey guys, check it out. We got one of those tin cans here.
Pick it up!
Look at this little motherfucker. You steal our jobs, but you can't even stand up.
We're gonna fuck your bitch ass up.
Yeah, waste it.
Do it!
Alright. It's enough. Leave it alone.
Let us teach this bastard a lesson.
If you damage it, I'm gonna have to find you.
You can take your job next. Let me see how you like it.
Okay. Let's go. One on one.
All right, that's it, guys. Markus, looks like his name is. Yep, Markus. So, that's how Detroit Become Human works. I hope you guys enjoyed how everything works, and I'll see you guys next time for the part 2 of Detroit Become Human. We'll see how the story continues off. But until then, I'll see you guys next time. Bye, everybody.